What's up, y'all? It's your girl Exclusive C, and I'm back with another video. This is my YouTube intro part two, where I'll be covering some of the things that I missed in my first YouTube intro. So we're gonna go into the Safari app and get the iPhone transparent. This is how I edit the iPhone into my video. You're gonna click images, and you're just gonna find the iPhone that has a white and gray checkerboard background, and save that into your phone. Then you're gonna, of course, look up your background that you want. It can be any background, and just add it to your photos. After that, you're gonna go into the Fonto app, click the camera icon at the bottom, plain image, the white image, the numbers above it, click custom, and in the first box you're going to type in 2560, and in the second box you're going to type in 1440. Done. Then click the square in the right corner and use the save. After that, you're going to click the three lines in the left, add image, all photos, and select the background image that you chose, and tap on the background image. And this will appear, and click size, and just make sure that the background covers the whole white square. And then just save it into your phone. Then we're gonna go into the eraser app. I did everything really out of order, so just bear with me. But the eraser app is what I use to delete the background of my images and the pictures that I wanted to use. You can watch the How I Made My Banner tutorial that I have the link to in my description. That shows how I use the PixArt app to delete most of it. And you can also watch my How to Make a YouTube Intro. That shows how I use the eraser app. After that, you're gonna go into the Fonto app again. Click on the camera icon, plain image, the white image once again, and this time just use and save it. And you're gonna just tap on the screen, add text will appear, and you just will be typing in your YouTube channel name. After you type in your YouTube channel name, just click font, and it's gonna give you a variety of different fonts that you can choose from. After you choose the font that you like, you're gonna click done. Drag it to the middle, size it to how you want to. And after you size it, just click style, and you have the option to change the color or whatever. And when you click stroke is what makes the outlining. And you're just gonna save that image. Then you'll go back into the eraser app and select the wording you just did and click erase target area, and make sure that the bullseye is on the color that you want to erase. It'll help erase the white faster. After you do that, you're going to save the image. Next, we're gonna go into the Cute Cut app, click on the plus sign, click create, done. Click the plus sign once again, click photo, and select the background. Double tap it and just drag it out so that it can equal to 20 seconds is what I always do, because I speed my video up sometimes. And after you do that, you're just gonna save it as high quality. This part is optional, so you're gonna go to the Pocket Video app, click plus, click the YouTube blog, and click the plus again, click on camera roll, and you're going to select the video that you created in Cute Cut app with the background. Once again, this part is optional. You're gonna go to video sticker, click on YouTube, and type in the green screen blink. This is how I got the blinking effect on the background of my video. You'll select that. Once it loads, you're gonna click done. After that, Normally, a green screen would pop up, but a green screen didn't pop up on this part. If a green screen does pop up, you're going to click mask, which you'll see me do. Click mask and just click green screen. And this is how my background appeared. Next, this part is also optional as well. You're just going to click add video sticker again. And I typed in the green screen hearts falling. Once again, type in green screen hearts falling. This part is optional. Next, you're just going to find whichever effect you like with the hearts falling. Once you find that, click done. Make sure that the whole screen is covered with the green screen like that. Click mask and green screen again, which it'll delete the green screen. Then you're just gonna finish it, click no, and just save it to your camera roll. Then you're gonna go back into the Cute Cut app, click the plus, click create, and click done. Click the plus sign again, click video, and click on the video that you just created. Then you'll click the plus sign again, click photo. This is all self-explanatory. You're just gonna add all the photos that you just used in the eraser app, all the photos you just created, the wording and everything. Just double tap it to stretch it out the link and just move it if you want to move it. If you want to add a transition to it so that it appear at a certain time, it'll disappear at a certain time, just click the wand at the bottom, click on the plus sign, and all these transitions will appear. And you can mess with the app, play around with it, and figure out which transition you prefer. I just continue to do that with each photo and with the wording, and this is how it appeared. Next, you're going to go back into the Fonto app, and this was highly requested as well. You're just going to repeat this same process that you did with the wording at the beginning, except this time I just did my social medias. I did the social medias. You do the social medias the same way that you just did the YouTube channel name at the beginning of the video. You type it in, save it. Use the colors that you want. Go back into the eraser app. Select the photo. Click on erase. Target area. And just delete all of the white. Okay, now I didn't include the part where I got the YouTube, the Instagram icon in the video. But if you watch the how to make an advanced YouTube intro video in my description box, you'll see how I got that part. It is the same exact way that I did the falling hearts in the flashing background. You just go back into the Pocket Video app and type in green screen social media. I didn't include that clip, but yes, that's how I got that Instagram icon right there. Then after that, I clicked on the plus sign, clicked on photo, and I selected the photo that I just made in Fonto with the Instagram name, and just tapped on the wording, dragged the wording so that it can fit in the white box right next to the Instagram icon and just size it so that it can fit and be positioned the right way. I did all my backgrounds the same way in the frontal app with the same ratio. I did all of my photos the same way with the eraser app, just clicking plus and adding transitions. So everything is really just a repeat. After you get the name how you want it in the social media box, I just linked it so that it can appear when the social media is there and so that it can disappear when the social media icon is gone. And all you do is save it to your camera roll. Next, to add the phone, all you do is click the plus and you're going to add the phone like this, add the phone, and then click the plus again and add the video that you want on top of the phone. And just like you did the social media and the icon, just size the video so that it can be directly on top of the phone and it'll look like this. Once again, everything is a repeat. I made my backgrounds the same. I made my pictures appear and disappear the same way as I showed you in the beginning. And the phone, all you have to do is add the phone picture and add the video picture and size the video so that it can be directly in the phone. Next, we're gonna go back into the Fonto app. Click the camera icon, plain image, the white image, and to click the numbers above and type in the same numbers that I did at the beginning. I'm just repeating how I did my background, I'm showing you how I'm doing the last background. I'm doing this background the same way that I did the beginning background, just a repeat. Everything is a repeat. Also, in the Pocket Video app, you're gonna repeat and do everything that I showed you at the beginning, but this time you're gonna type in the subscribe green screen. This is how I got the like subscribe button to be in my video, and you'll just find the like and subscribe video that you like, click done, click mask, and click green screen. Once again, everything is just a repeat. You can size it to how you want it to be, and boom, and finish it and add music. No, if you want to know how I added music, just make sure you watch the video in my description box on how I made my first YouTube advanced intro. And thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Also, comment things that you would like for me to do. And to combine all the videos together, I just used the iMovie app, which is right here. And thank you. And here is the finishing video.
Things that you heard about, nothing good comes when you're searching for the wrong things. What it feels off when I come around, asking me questions like, what do I believe in? You.